Your favorite album.
Oh. Okay. You know that there are like 117 million people living in Mexico. There is 316 cases of coronavirus, and there's two dead in the whole.
Holy shit. Lock everything down right now.
It's fucking crazy, man. I mean,
it is
crazy. You have any idea how many people die in this country every day to normal things?
I know. It's insane.
117 million here living.
Right.
316 cases, two dead in the whole fucking country.
Right. It'll get worse. What's
happening? No, I don't think so.
Don't think so?
Because everybody's isolating.
They're seeing what's happening here now and they're going to be smart about it and do it now.
Yeah.
Well, that's good because they should.
I don't know. That's what the Illuminati wants.
We will get martial, what do they call it? Martial law. That will happen here.
Yeah.
And
I heard about that.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw the stuff you posted the other day.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. What about the thing with the, what the hell's his name? Tom Hanks.
I gotta get him. I just saw the pedophile accusation.
Yeah. I've heard a lot about that stuff, but I don't know. For them to go through all this stuff just to get Tom Hanks and a whole bunch of other actors, I don't know. It's a little far-fetched to me.
Yeah.
But hey, you never know.
Yeah.
So what have you been up to?
Composing and giving lessons.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You seem like you've been very busy lately.
Yeah.
Was there shows going on or something?
No, my show was postponed.
Okay. Till when?
Until 4th of April.
Oh, all right. So not too long.
Yeah.
Unless it gets worse there. Then,
No, because there's no official quarantine in Monterrey, but people are staying inside, a lot of people.
Yeah. Do you notice, are people getting freaked out now?
Yeah, but I'm not scared, so I go out.
Yeah.
Every day.
You've been through enough shit. You can get through this.
Yes, of course I will.
Anything else you want to talk about the coronavirus?
Should I put this to my Facebook that it's on live?
Yeah, you should have did it already, yeah.
Should I put the link?
No, let people wonder where it is. Yes, yes, put the link. Ask me a silly question like that. Unbelievable. So, yeah, everything's locked down here. And I don't know. I still got to work. My wife has to work. There's still people out on the roads. The grocery stores are still packed. People don't want to stay home. They're at the beach.
Really?
Yeah.
Good. I like that.
I don't know. My mother tried to take my son to the beach the other day. And I was like, you know what? Just don't take him.
Yeah?
Because you never know. It could be one asshole. Actually, I was on Facebook earlier. And there was a thing about kids going to grocery stores and like coughing all over the groceries now. Exactly.
I closed the WhatsApp because otherwise it's like,
a good idea. But yeah, you never know who you're near. You know, somebody can have it and give it to you, and God forbid. I'm not too worried about it because, you know, I don't have any pre-existing conditions or anything, but you never know.
Yeah. I closed the WhatsApp now, and I posted in the
It's about time.
Facebook.
Good. I'm glad.
Okay.
All right. I saw you hung out with Fabio Leone the other day.
How'd yes. go? That's like fucking 2 weeks ago.
It was that long ago, really?
Yeah.
Wow. Didn't seem that long ago. Well, how'd it go anyway?
Well, it was like a fucking 10 years since I saw him.
Yeah.
I was nice. I mean, I didn't see that Turilli was somewhere.
Oh, were they doing Rhapsody or something?
Yeah.
Oh, really? Okay.
Rhapsody, yeah. And I met Anders. And you know who tried to call me during the weekend?
Michael Kiske.
Mr. DeMaio.
Oh, geez. What the heck would he want?
So he sent me emails and stuff, and he's going to call me again today.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Don't do it.
He's doing it. I didn't pick it up because it was an unknown call.
Yeah. No, talk to him. But yeah, I would seeing all the things that happened between Rhapsody, I don't know if that's a good idea.
Yeah, I don't know. But I did meet Anders. So.
Yeah, how'd that go?
Good.
Yeah.
He's a very fuck strong with this camera. Like probably, sideways.
It's probably the person that's on the other side. No, you. That's what's wrong. You're fine. I don't know what's your problem.
Because I'm like sideways.
No, you look normal.
You're straight. Now he's straight, but if I'm like.
It is what it is. What are you going to do?
I put something under this.
Most of the time, your head is all the way in the screen, so it doesn't matter.
Well, I need to get it perfect because I'm a producer.
Now that we're on the 14th episode, now you're going to start getting professional.
See? Now it's perfect.
Yeah. I'm surprised it even works. You posted a picture earlier, and you had the coffee or whatever spilt all over your keyboard.
Not all over. It's three drops.
It doesn't matter. Don't get anything on the keyboard.
Shit, it's true. I put it down.
Why would you even put any drink or anything near your keyboard? All your music is in your computer, and you'd be screwed.
You know, they're putting Hymn to Life and Classical Variations to Spotify.
I saw you post that. Thank God. It's about time.
I sold my soul to the devil.
What'd you have to do to get that on there?
My manager is doing it. I don't know what he did.
No.
He gave it to Orchid, I think.
Yeah.
Just via Orchid.
All right. What the hell's Orchid? I have no idea.
It's something to do with YouTube.
No, all right. Yeah. Well, why would have YouTube have to do with Spotify? That he owns
because Orchid, I guess, owns part of Spotify.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. But anyway, it's going to be there in 2 weeks, both of them.
Oh, good. Thank God.
Only one song he had to leave out from classical. That's like this guitar concerto, this Aranjuez, because of the copyright issues.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah.
One song. At least most of the album is there.
Yes. And Hymn to Life completely.
Thank God.
Yeah.
It's about time. People have been waiting and crying for that album.
But I refuse to pay the fucking Spotify that I get my music there.
I don't pay for it either. Just use the free one.
No, I mean, if you want to have your album in Spotify, you have to pay to them.
Oh, fuck them.
Yeah. It's like this Rata Blanca. You know that band?
No.
It's from Argentina. Jens played one song.
No, I have no idea.
They are very famous here in Latin America. And their manager called me and asked, Timo, we want you to produce the next Rata Blanca. I said, okay. You know, then he said, but you have to pay us. And that's the first time in my 25-year career that I hear that the producer has to pay to the band.
Yeah, not happening.
It never happened.
That makes absolutely no sense.
What the fuck could I say? Okay, man, this is really not the way it works, you know. I mean, you pay me if I produce you.
Yeah, that's usually how that works.
Yes.
And I thought usually when you go to Spotify, you have to, I don't know, there's this other website where you go to have all your shit put on. I don't know what it is. A friend of mine showed me.
Yeah.
But, and I know you have to pay for that, but it's usually just like a one-time fee or something, I thought.
Right.
I don't know. What do I know?
I think there are several platforms that can take you there without money.
Yeah. Yeah, there's always a way around something.
Yeah. Is there anybody online?
There are two people here. Oh, and nobody's running. Two people, yes. That makes up for the two people that are dead in Monterey now.
No, in Mexico.
Mexico. Sorry. Yeah. I thought Monterey it was in Mexico.
In Monterey, there's none.
None?
Yes.
Not yet.
No. Can you understand every day how many people die normally in a country that has 170 million people?
Yeah. I know, but you know what it is? It's the rate that it's happening, and it's the hospitals don't have the room for all these people.
Yeah.
You know? That's what's really the problem.
Well, it's also that they don't know when it's coronavirus or normal flu.
Right.
Some people think we have a, I have a coronavirus, but it's just a fucking flu.
Right, yeah.
And one of the things that was weird is like, Kiske said that it's just a fucking flu in the email. And he even wrote it like flu, F-L-E-U, F-L-E-W, flu. That flu.
I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, it's bad. And hopefully it comes to an end soon so everybody can stop going crazy. Because I see all these people I see on Facebook, they must have no hobbies whatsoever because they're going crazy. And it's only been in lockdown for like 2 days.
Yeah.
I don't get it. I have so many things I could do. I'm not bored. I'd rather stay home.
Mm.
I don't get it.
Well, I have to write an album, so I got
to. You have things to do. People, you know, need to find things to do. Brian, I'm not pronouncing that last name, but he said, hey, and it's the flu, bro. That's what he says.
It's the flu, bro. What does it mean?
It's the flu.
Yeah,
that's it. He just thinks it's just the flu.
Yeah.
We'll see. Hopefully this ends and we'll find out.
Yeah.
I saw
like a World Health Organization press conference where they say it's going to be over in a month.
Right. It hasn't peaked yet. It hasn't got to the worst part yet. So we'll see what happens.
Mm-hmm.
I still got to work. I'm still okay.
Yeah,
I don't know. Although it did scare me the other day, I saw it said something about 80% of the people in New York City will get the coronavirus.
Bullshit.
That's what it said.
But the media is doing this.
Yes, I know. And that's kind of what sucks. They should just kind of not try to scare everybody, which is why all the grocery stores are selling out of food and everything. And they just put everybody in a panic. Yeah. And have you seen the lines at the grocery stores?
Yes.
And people aren't supposed to be within 6 feet of each other.
Yeah.
It's stupid.
Yeah.
Oh, he said it's an internet meme. It's the flu, bro. Yeah.
It's the flu, bro.
It's just the flu, bro. I've never seen that.
That's what the Manowar guys were saying to Anders. Just the flu.
Oh, boy.
I guess in Italy, it's not just the flu.
No. No, it definitely is not just the flu in Italy. I don't know what the hell's going on in Italy.
They have like 500 people dead every day.
Half of Italy will be gone by the end of this show.
Our frontiers will be gone. I hope the fucking virus targets exactly Via Gonzaga 74, Naples.
Oh, boy. No, I hope everybody's in Italy. I hope our friend Francesco is okay and his mother, I know, is...
They are okay, but not... No, I shouldn't say
not that. Anybody we don't know.
Yeah.
Hope everybody gets well and everything's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
And we can get through this. Well, today we're going to talk about your favorite album.
Black Album.
The Black Album.
Yeah.
I was listening to this the other day, and like everybody else when this came out, yeah. I didn't know what the hell to think about this album. What is that? Barbecue sauce?
Yeah. Hunt. Little commercial here.
Oh, good.
People buy this. It's against the coronavirus.
our sponsors is Hunt. Oh, here's a question. Alexis wants to know, what do you think about the...
Where is he from?
I don't know. Oh, he's from Mexico City.
Okay.
What do you think about the boom of festivals in Latin America? Do you think it's not profitable for bands to do standalone shows anymore?
It's profitable for me. There is actually my shows, and I'm going to have, I think, here in Mexico, a lot of shows.
Right.
Yeah. And my Brazilian tour will happen in July.
It's going to happen. It's not canceled yet, right?
No, it's not. They don't want to postpone it.
Yeah.
No. Is this, what has this Alexis like last name?
Afendoulis? Afendoulis. Something like that.
I don't know. I mean, I think it's profitable if you find like, if I do it like me, it's like you find the local musicians to do it with.
Yeah.
Then it's for profitable. But if I bring my band, then no. You see what happened to Rhapsody? They had 14 gigs and they only could do two.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and they couldn't like, get the refunds from the flights, so they're fucked. Hmm. They lost like 40,000 euros.
Really?
So they are doing some kind of a crowdfunding campaign to people who give them money so they can come back.
Oh, that works.
Yeah.
That's not too bad of an idea. What the hell is this? Who's Marcel? And how the hell did they join in my thing here? Let me see what happens. Let me see who it is. Hold on a minute. We'll get to the Black Album in a second. Hello?
Hello?
Who the hell are you?
I'm fine.
What's up? How did you get into my chat? I have no idea.
Sorry.
who was that?
I don't know. Let's kick him from the studio. Boom. Gone.
how did he get into there?
I have no idea. I didn't send anybody my link. Are you sending the link out to people?
Yes, I did.
No, I mean that. Oh wait, did you just you didn't send the StreamYard thing, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, you're not supposed to send that out.
I thought that's what I'm supposed to send.
No, you're supposed to send the YouTube thing out.
No, everybody's coming.
Yeah, no wonder why.
Sorry.
Hold on a minute here. Hold up, everybody. Send this link. I'm putting it in your messenger right now. Put up this link.
I hate the fucking messenger.
Not that one. Sorry, Marcel. I thought you were just some stranger. I apologize.
Timo Tolkki. Timo Tolkki.
Anyway, so for the Black Album, you had a lot of shit going on after the Elements album.
Wait, I put the link. Episode 14.
Episode 14.
Yeah, we had.
Yeah. The band had a lot of shit going on.
The band had, yeah.
What are you trying to look it up on Wikipedia? I could do that for you.
No, it's like
you don't remember? I know what you're doing. You're looking at your freaking WhatsApp. All right, Wikipedia. During this period of 2004, increasing tensions were starting in the band. And the band temporarily disbanded after you suffered a nervous breakdown, which is when you got diagnosed with bipolar disorder. During this time, Timo released his second solo album. How did you feel about him doing his solo albums? You didn't care?
Him to life?
No, not yours. The other Timo.
Well, he had to do his stuff.
Yeah.
I had no problem with it.
No problem.
No?
No, I wouldn't think you would have, but I don't
know. I could, but I didn't.
Yeah. Did you not want him to do it at one point?
No. I always told him to do his own stuff because I didn't like his songs.
Good reason.
I just didn't like them. That's all. Yeah. It's nothing like nothing personal.
Right. Yeah, no, of course, you know.
Yeah.
It's also during this time that Stratovarius orchestrated a series of publicity stunts. We went through this on our first interview we did with you.
Yeah.
The publicity stunts. These were very fun. You fired Cody Pelto and replaced him with a female singer, Katrina Kay. Yeah. And this one I forgot about. You were stabbed at a concert.
Yeah, and Jens pissed on me.
And Jens pissed on you. Yes, that's right.
Or forever.
And I forgot you were stabbed at a concert. What the hell was that about? I don't remember that.
I was never stabbed. It was part of the fun.
So nobody really stabbed you?
No, the photos were taken in Helsinki. Like with a makeup artist.
Oh, okay.
I had like a bruised eye and a stabbing wounds here.
I see. I don't remember that. I have to look that up.
Yeah. There's a video of Jens pissing me on forever.
Yes, that everybody's seen that one. That was pretty funny.
Yes. And I had a shirt which is Jesus is coming, and in the back, Jesus is going. I mean, so I was obviously manic at that
time. Right, right.
Because I wrote the whole fucking thing. I wrote like a script, like a Hollywood script.
Right.
Like, this happens this day, this happens this day, this happens this day. Funny thing happened because it was called Björnorok, where the stabbing and pissing happened. So we had Lufthansa flight from Helsinki, and we took off, and the other engine failed.
Oh, okay.
So we had to return and change the plane. It's like a warning that don't do it.
Right. And you did it anyway.
Yeah, of course. I was manic.
Oh, and Marcel finally joined the chat here. It's okay, Marcel. I apologize before. I didn't realize Timo gave the link out to come into the chat.
I thought that's silly.
I know. Silly, silly man. Yeah. Alexis wants to know what happened to the DV shot in Brazil during the tour.
Well, we couldn't use it because the way it was like mic'd, the whole thing. It's like the vocals were everywhere, and that show, he wasn't so good. Mm. So we couldn't do it. We couldn't use it. And it was like 6,000 people in Via Funchal.
Wow.
Yeah.
Let's see. Okay. And after you were stabbed, eventually you revealed the stunts were a hoax.
Yeah.
And you reunited the band and began to work on the Black Album.
Yeah.
It was released to hostile reception by the fans.
Well, the song Zenith of Power was originally called Hitler.
Oh, this is the Hitler song. Okay. Yes.
So I got two guys from Sanctuary Berlin coming to my studio in Helsinki, and I played them the songs, and then this song came. I said, this song is called Hitler. It's like 1 minute silence, like Timo, you know, you can't do this. I said, why not? It's an anti-Hitler song. It's anti-Nazi song. Jens was on my side. He was defending me. Jörg Michael called me to the studio, and he sounded exactly like Hitler on the phone. I'm going to leave the fucking band. You know. Then I was like, okay, let's change it. And now it's Zenith of Power, Götterdämmerung. It's from Wagner opera.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, it's good that you changed it.
Jörg Michael played the whole fucking drums alone in the studio without anybody.
Oh, wow.
The whole fucking album is played to a click without any, not even guide guitars.
Right.
Yeah.
Really?
I was in a hospital at that time, but I couldn't go to the studio. I did the initial miking and sounds and everything, but then I collapsed and went to the hospital.
Hmm. So what happened during that whole thing when you went to the hospital and everything?
It was like one morning I woke up, I had felt this pressure in my head. Like, so I called to the like emergency number, and they said maybe you have like a stroke. Mm-hmm. So I went to a local, I lived that time where my brother and my mother is living, Klaukkala. So I went to a hospital and she gave me like Xanax. I said, what? And then I went to Helsinki to a private doctor. And he took me in immediately, and I saw him riding the famous rock star. I saw it on the screen. I said, your place is in a mental hospital. And I said, no way, man. I'm not going to go there because I know exactly how they are.
Right.
Because I knew they have a hospital in that place. I said, you know, you have a hospital here, right? He would look at me. Yes. You know how much it costs? 700 euros a day.
Wow.
But I said, okay, let's take me in. And I was there 4 days, and that's when I had the consultation of a psychiatrist who diagnosed me with bipolar type disorder 2, 2004.
Wow.
And he gave me Depakote first, but then it was changed to lithium.
Jeez.
Yeah.
And now you're not using anything, right?
No, or you are? Nothing. No, only like normal medicines, like blood pressure stuff.
Yeah. Well, that's good. You're able to manage it all yourself now, I guess.
Yes. I would say because, you know, bipolar cannot be cured. It's right. an incurable illness.
Right.
But what is bipolar? Because you know the life of a musician. You play one night to 3,000 people, they're like fucking mayhem. Then you go to the hotel room, you're like, where am I?
Right, yeah.
So it takes like hours to get the energy down.
Get back
to
normal, like, yeah.
And the next day, the same. So it is like bipolar, the life of a musician.
Right. Although music helps, though, right? When you're making songs, right?
Yes. I mean, that always helped me. That really always did the trick.
Yeah. Marcel, our special guest here. Why do you think the Black Album is such an album criticized by people? For me, it's a great album.
Because it's not a typical power metal album.
No.
You know, I mean, you have to understand that ever since the episode, Visions, Destiny, Infinity, Elements, where can you go from there?
All right.
It's like these go to 11. Why don't you make the 11 like the 10? Disco to 11. It's like there's only because I really knew after Elements that where the fuck can you go from there? And then I did what I did. I just composed the songs, man. And but there was the stunt. I was manic, Maniac Dance, all these songs, Biscay, the fucking stunt. I mean, Jens Johansson was really into it. he told me many things to do. He told me like take a taxi, stop it by the sea, run to the forest while you are undressing, swim behind the like, and there are guys with the helicopter taking you to Estonia. And then they drop you down on the beach of Estonia. You go naked to the terminal of the boats. Like, and in the next day would be in Finnish magazine, Tolkki swam to the Estonia. he also said, let's rent a car and set it on fire, drink one bottle of vodka, sit and wait for the police to come. But the car would be on fire. When, no, I mean, come on, even I didn't. So it's like... Well,
thank God you didn't do the naked one.
But I have to say one thing. I'm still the only one who publicly took responsibility of this stunt. And that is something I don't like.
Right.
Because everybody was behind it, man.
Yeah.
Even Kotipelt told me, if this works, you are a genius.
Hmm.
Those were his, I remember still, those were exactly his words.
What made you want to tell everybody it was a hoax? Why didn't you just keep it like it was all real?
Because I wanted to tell them the truth, because it was wrong towards the fans.
Yeah.
That's why.
It was kind of weird, because it was just like out of nowhere, you know?
Everybody freaked out, of course.
Yes, yeah, so the most freaky part was, well, I mean, all the other stuff you did, but having all the members in the band gone.
Not all.
Almost all, most of them. Well, the important ones, well, I shouldn't say that, but, you know, everybody's important. But
even Anders joined one point.
Really?
Anders was in Stratovarius for 1 week. Then the Hammerfall guy saw that. What are you doing? Because Anders Johansson joined Stratovarius in 1 week. Anders Johansson quit Stratovarius.
Now, with this album, you had no double bass whatsoever.
Really?
Yeah, there was no double bass on this whole album. And I remember reading a thing that's you specifically didn't want any double bass on this album at all.
I don't know, but I just wrote the songs, man. I don't think it was like deliberate. It just... You know, people want the Black Diamonds and Forever Freeze and Father Times and whatever. So you cannot forever do those.
Yeah, you can. There are bands that do.
Not me. No.
You don't think so?
If anybody wants to give me a really good advice for the like what kind of album the Avalon should be, please send it to my email ttolkki777@gmail.com. Which is also available for Skype lessons.
It's not Skype, it's just called Skype. You don't pronounce the E.
In Finland, it's Skype.
No, it's not.
It's Skype. Like you'd say, Timo, old chap. Hey, Timo, old chap.
No, it's Timo.
But you Americans say Timo.
Timo.
Timo, old chap.
Did I say Timo?
You never said Timo.
No, I never said Timo.
Here they say Timo.
Timo.
Here they say Timo.
Right. Yeah,
Timmo. I'm here, Timmo.
they elongate the M.
Oh, here I'm known as Pedro Ramirez.
Yes, I know that. Yeah. Who gave you that name?
Some fan. Pedro Ramirez Tolkki. Or I like Lauri Porra said, "This is El Tolkki, the name that strikes fear throughout the people in Latin America. Well, the name who strikes fear in the hearts of the people in Latin America." That was Lauri Porra.
Okay. All right. So now, like you said, Jordan Michael, he didn't use any tracks for the album, like guitar tracks or whatever. So what did the rest of the guys do?
Oh, they were just waiting. you know. I mean, then I when I felt better, we started to do guitar, bass. I mean, there's a documentary, a mini documentary about the making of this album.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's called something like Mini Rockumentary in YouTube.
Oh, I missed all this shit. You told me about that the last album, too.
I can send you the link later. But it's like, I had my own studio at that time in Helsinki. I bought, from the Elements royalties, I bought fucking SSL for 80,000 euros from Paris.
Right.
And that desk arrived on my birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, yeah. It was happy birthday, man. But
it was my birthday, by the way, on Thursday. You didn't wish me happy birthday.
But... Oh, happy birthday, my friend.
Thanks.
How many years? 64?
No, 41.
41?
Yeah.
The fuck, you're too young. You're a baby.
I know I am. Thank God.
Yeah.
Unaffected by this coronavirus. Doesn't hit anybody over...
Fuck the virus. Fuck the virus. Two people dead in Mexico. Mexico in the country.
And I keep touching my face. See, I can't help it.
Look at guys. Sorry.
Don't do that.
No, it's like... no, it's like... it was SSL G4000 Plus, the same desk that in Finvox.
Okay.
Like a dream come true. But only two albums were made. Thunderstone and Stratovarius Black.
What's the Thunderstone? That's a band, right?
Yeah, it's an album which has a song called Tool of the Devil. Maybe this album is called Tool of the Devil.
No, I don't know.
That was done there. But anyway, we started to do then bass, guitars, vocals, and I mixed the whole thing there. And I did the same thing that Elements. I put the drums through the PA.
Hmm. Yeah, it's got a cool drum sound, a nice live sound to it.
Yeah, yeah.
What did the band think about this album? Did they not want to do this one? Were they not?
They were into this one because it does have some songs. Back to Madness is great. I mean,
when I listened to this the other day, there are good songs on here. I think now it's one of those albums where at the time nobody wanted this because they wanted power metal stuff. But
yeah,
it's one of those albums that it needs time to grow. You know?
Yeah.
Because Maniac Dance, and Just Carry On. There's a lot of really cool songs on here.
The Land of Ice and Snow.
Yeah, there really isn't any bad songs.
United,
Zenith Power.
I like Zenith Power. There is a speech of Hitler in the end. It's there, but it's very low in the mix.
Right. Yeah. Not to listen to it. I didn't catch it.
It's there.
That's the only one I really didn't care for.
Yeah. I like it because it has this Metallica feel,
right?
Yeah. You know, and Metallica's Black Album was like my aim. Yeah. Of course, we didn't have the budget and stuff. I mean, you know, so I mean, the Maniac Dance. Have you seen the video
of what
Maniac Dance?
We are actually going to watch that later after this.
Ah, cool. Because there's a story. There's a story to tell.
All right, good. We'll talk about that story during the video.
Okay.
We're adding a new segment to the show, everybody.
Yeah.
Marcel says, an album that has songs like United that transmit so much, I still don't understand how many people didn't like it.
How does he know how many people didn't like it?
Well, I did say what did it say here?
Nice Wikipedia.
There was a hostile reception when this album came out.
What is a hostile reception?
People were fucking in the streets saying, burn this fucking album. That's what they were saying.
One thing that did happen was that's the first time I had to submit the lyrics to the German governmental section called Bundesprüfstelle, which checks the lyrics.
How do you remember saying all these names?
Because I have a good memory.
Oh, shit. Whoops, I dropped it. That's not funny.
You dropped the thing.
I did. The album cover, I mean, it's just a plain old, whatever you call it. What do you call that thing? Here, that symbol there. The symbol.
Fleur de lis. It's right here.
Who did that?
Juho Juntunen, Finnish journalist.
You should have somebody that's a good artist redo it.
Well, I didn't want to do this fucking cactus.
Like, what was he, 5 years old when he did it? Looks no, terrible.
Fucking 100 years old. But I have the 777s too. You see?
Very good. When did you start getting tattoos? You didn't always have tattoos.
I have 4 tattoos.
Wow.
And one here, 666, my birthday.
Yeah.
Oh, there was something else. I'm the beast, dude.
You are. Yeah, I think you are the beast.
I am the beast. I'm the beast.
What else happened during this album? I'm going to read something here for a second. What else happened? Anything else happened during the recording of this album? Any mishaps?
It was like first time Timo was using like a handheld mic for some of the songs. Like Maniac Dance was sure 58. And we were experimenting with the vocals more than before. And he was singing with more strength, more like maybe a rougher voice, like Back to Madness is.
Mm-hmm.
In the end of the Back to Madness, I there was like 4 guys in the studio. I gave them like a book to each of the guys, different book. And I told them to read aloud. Then I recorded that. And that's like in the end of the song, it's like describing the madness inside of your head.
Mm.
And then there is this poem which was done by Starbuck. He's like a wrestler in Helsinki. Like, have you ever been hurt? Have you ever been truly scared? From the moment we are born, we are dying. It's like the poem.
It's so my he was poem. A wrestler?
Yeah. Oh, okay. He still is.
Oh, really?
A heavy Christian. So Christian wrestler.
Interesting. There's a lot of those.
I think he fights with Jesus every day. He wrestles with Jesus.
Marcel, are there demos of the Black Album?
We didn't do any demos.
No demos.
No.
No demos,
Marcel. I mean, there must have been, because it's the always I did demos that I gave to the band. And they were always like, what the fuck is this now, Timo? Every fucking album since episode, it was the same.
Yeah.
Every album.
Did you write any songs for this album that were more power metal-ish at all?
No.
Or was there any other leftover songs at all for this album?
I never do that. I always write the songs that really come.
Yeah.
It's a safe statement of the time.
Yeah. In 2005, you fired Yari.
Yes. With a text message.
With a text. And it says actually, here,
no, it was not a text message.
Well, 2005, we had phones, so yeah. Would you send him an email?
No, I was in the concert of U2 in Germany, and we were texting, and me and him having an argument. And Kotipelto and Jens were in London giving interviews. I told them by a text message, I'm going to fire this guy. And we had a listening session in Helsinki, and he wanted to bring his girlfriend, his Yoko Ono, to everywhere, to the parties, to the. I said, no, Yari, nobody's bringing the girl. Said, oh, no. Then I quit. So he left the band. I didn't fire him.
Oh, well, it says here he was fired in 2005 following the release of the album. No. And you said, Tolkki said, the reason why he was fired was so absurd that you're not even going to explain it here.
Well, no, I did. But he chose to leave.
Yeah.
Yeah. He chose to leave.
All right. You sure about that?
Yes. That has to be corrected.
I'm going to change Wikipedia right now.
Yeah. Can you do that?
Forced to leave. Yeah, you actually can. You can edit there. You can change everything. You just have to give a reason why you're doing it. Alexis, did Jorg Michael say something about firing of Jari?
He didn't say. Nobody said, because he was not fired. He left.
Well, he wrote that 2 seconds before you said that. Let's see. Marcel, my question comes since there are many Timo tapes with an acoustic guitar humming the lyrics of Elements. Oh, he was. I guess he's heard a lot of your acoustic guitar stuff with the, I guess, demos of you doing them.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's why he asked about the demos.
Well, there must have been.
I'm sure there is demos.
But you know me, I don't have anything.
No. You lost it all.
I lost it all.
How was the tour for this album? Did anybody give a shit? Did anybody come out?
I don't think there was a tour. I mean, there was an American tour.
Yeah.
That's the first American tour. We had like 16 shows.
2005. You were together that long in 2005. You finally came to America.
2005 or 2006.
Wow.
And it was like I had a fucking bodyguard.
Really?
Yeah, because Jörg Michael wanted me to have a bodyguard. That was Tom Zimmermann from Berlin. Tom Zimmermann was like the guy who brought Lord of the Rings to Europe in a fucking case.
Oh, really?
He was the bodyguard of Tom Cruise.
Ah, uh-huh, nice.
Yes.
Did he have any stories about Tom Cruise?
Yes.
What? Like what?
Like the girls were approaching him all the time. Like two girls. If we can go to Tom, you can have us. He told me. And he was a guy who was always there, but he was never anywhere. I said, somehow saw his head like, then. I just still don't know why I had like bodyguard, because I never really needed one, because it was a fucking stunt.
Right. Yeah.
And I remember because I bought John Deere shirt. I told you the story, right?
Yes, you did. Yeah. You can tell people since there's people here.
Well, it's like,
it's funny.
I was in Saskatoon in Canada, Saskatchewan, and had a day off, and I went to the supermarket and I saw a really cool shirt, like John Deere. What's that? Is that deer? Deer. So I bought the shirt. It's green and gray. And then we had a gig in LA in Key Club next to the Rainbow Bar. Hmm. So I was walking in the Sunset Boulevard with this shirt, and everybody was laughing their ass off. Like, what? Then somebody, you know, Timo, what is this shirt? It's a fucking tractor shirt.
It's a very famous tractor.
Now I know, but I really just thought it looks cool, man.
Good thing you didn't put it on an album cover. You would have been screwed.
That would have been great.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Magnus writes, do you remember that you make a solo on the Insania album? Nope.
It's Insania.
If you got to think about it that long, you don't remember. Insania, well, the band from Stockholm.
Did I do the solo?
Magnus says you probably did, yeah.
Probably. Mm-hmm. I do remember that we were somehow touched with these Christians, this Karl-Johan Grimmark, Narnia.
Narnia, yes. Narnia is a good band. Yeah, I like them.
Okay.
You don't like them?
It's like,
is it because they're Christian?
No, it's like I don't remember this Insania thing. I remember I was in Phoenix listening to them when they recorded. I don't remember doing a solo. Mm. I don't think I did a solo.
You probably did. You know what? Let's disprove you. Timo Tolkki.
Can I go to the toilet?
No, absolutely not.
I have to wait. I'll be back in
30 seconds. I gotta go too. And I'm sitting. Oh my God, you're gonna leave me here alone.
I come back, wait.
Hurry up, quick. Meanwhile, while you're doing that, we're live and he's leaving the show. That's pretty fucked up. Anyway, what's everybody doing out there? Let me know what you're doing. Mr. Perko, I can't pronounce that. I'm not editing any of this either because we're live. I'm trying to find where Insania solo projects. No, playing statement. Other appearances. Here we go. It is not listed on appearances. He's done Edguy, Avantasia, Thunderstone, Gimmel, Beto Vasquez, Infinity, Dreamtail, and Ring of Fire. Insania is not on here. Oh, so it's a different Insania. Yes, I hope he does not go into the bathroom and bring the phone with him or the computer. Mr. Perkele was Timo. I don't know. We'll have to ask him that when he comes back. Yes, we are all staying home. Although I do have to work, so I cannot stay home. I have a job that is very essential to the American people here. The
official peace break is over.
Yes, we were hoping you weren't going to take the computer with you.
No, nobody wants to see that.
Magnus,
to see.
There is nothing to see. No. Magnus called you Mr. Percolet.
Magnus?
Yeah.
Magnus who?
Magnus Lofgren.
Mr. Percolet.
Percolet, yes.
Okay.
That's what that guy Mario was calling you from Sirius Black.
Yeah. Mr. Percolet.
No idea what that means. What else are we doing?
Percolet means devil.
Oh, yes, that's right. Devil. Yep. What the fuck was it? I see you distracted me here. You are the devil.
Yes. I'm the, right, favorite, the beast of the apocalypse.
Do you have a favorite song off the Black Album?
Back to Madness, definitely.
Yeah. I think that is one of the best ones on here, I think.
It has a cello part by Eikka Topinen of Apocalyptica.
Wait, what?
The cello part was played by the guy from Apocalyptica.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. How did you hook it up?
Because I know them. And I mic'd the cello, which is like $40,000 cello. I put the mic in there, it failed to the cello. Okay. Oops. Hey, that's the beginning. And there's this opera singer who was a friend of Cotibel. Like this.
What is Maniac Dance about? I always thought that was a funny name for a song.
Well, it's about my insane behavior.
Okay, that's what I kind of had a feeling it was. Dead air.
It's like... turn the phone off. Okay, I turn it off.
We have 13 people watching the show, and you're on your phone.
Because I have some...
And then before, you're worried about how straight your computer camera is, and you're trying to be professional, now you're unprofessional. Even better, put the phone in front of the screen so people can see the phone instead. Marcel wants to know, which guitars did you record the Black Album with? All at ESP?
ESP Black. It was the ESP Black with this exactly the lily from the cover. You know.
Cover of what?
Cover of the fucking album.
Oh, this cover?
Yeah. By the way, if somebody wants my WhatsApp, it's this.
Nobody can see that. What is it? There's nothing there.
iPhone.
There's nothing there.
Of course I'm not going to give my WhatsApp.
You do anyway. It's on Facebook.
Nah. It's not on Facebook. It's the wrong number.
It's a different number now? You changed the numbers?
I have 8 different numbers.
What a slut.
I'm just a musical prostitute, my dear.
Yes, you are.
Freddie Mercury.
Right. Andrew wants to know if you're back with ESP, which I believe you are, right?
I am, yes. I have the fucking contract, man. And I am... But you see, they're gonna send them to Prague, and nobody can enter Czech Republic. And I heard that they're going to close the borders for 2 years.
2 years?
That's what I heard. But I think they're just scaring the other European countries to do some better work. Because if Czech Republic closes the borders for 2 years, it's fucking dead because it lives from the tourism.
Right.
So this just, you know.
They can't do that for 2 years. No, there's no way.
Come on, nobody said that. I never heard that. No, but I'm going to have ESP here in Monterey from the shop, local shop. Oh, okay. So I am with ESP because I was with them like 15 years and they made me like about 14 guitars and I broke 4 of them on stage. I particularly remember one time in Madrid in a bullfighting arena with AC/DC. We had a show and I had like horrible sound because I had Marshall JCM 800, which is what I absolutely hate. It's only good for fishing. In a fishing chair, you sit on it and you fish ice fish in Finland. In Finnish, it's called pilkkipenki. So I had this fucking horrible sound. I was playing 4,000 Rainy Nights. I saw like fucking break this guitar, and I was hesitating. I looked at the audience, and I saw a guy with a Nike shirt. Just do it. Fuck. And to my defense, I have to say, I always threw all the pieces to the people. Every time I broke it, So I broke four ESPs. My first guitar I ever had, my Landola nylon string, which I had when I was 7, I broke at home when I was drunk. I broke one ESP in Finnish Metal Expo with Sinfonia.
Why?
Because it's fun to break guitars, man.
I guess if you're getting them for free, it's fun.
Yes. But I gave a lot to the clubs. There is one in Osaka called Rock Rock. It's my red ESP is there.
Interesting.
Behind the glass, like in a holy place.
You gave it to them?
Yes.
Edgar CBJ. Greetings, Timo. Do you still have the guitar used on Sinfonia records?
Sinfonia 7. No, I don't. I sold it.
Oh, you didn't smash it and break it?
I didn't smash that one, no.
And Andrew wants to know, what ESP model are you getting?
I don't know. I forgot. A guitar, guitar. No, it's a good one.
All right. Are you going to get any designs put on it or anything?
No, not this time. It's just like one of their models, I think. Interesting. But it's with Los Angeles ESP.
A Christian wants to know, any other songs exist of the 2005-2007 era?
Well, that era I wrote Revolution Renaissance songs.
Yeah, whatever happened to the, because after this Black album, there was supposed to be another album with the two letters RR, which actually became Revolution Renaissance.
Yeah.
Were the songs for that album the ones that you were writing for the next Stratovarius album?
Yes. Yeah. I wrote them, but we made the demos and we even tried to record the album.
Yeah.
But it didn't work. I edited drums for 1 week and I couldn't get them together. And everybody was like, what's happening? And nobody had the energy. And Jörg Michael said we should have the Vision Spirit back, but he didn't have it.
Yeah.
So I just said, guys, you know, this is the end. You know, we have to go like... Right. And everybody knows the story. I gave them the rights to the name and stuff. So.
Yeah. Now, how come you gave them the rights to the name and not just say, screw you, it's my name, we're just going to get a new band?
Well, I gave them the name and I said, screw you.
Yes, we all know that. Yeah. A lot of back and forth afterwards.
Yeah. They call me Greedy Narcissistic Faust.
But how come you let them take the name?
Because I realized that I don't do nothing with the name anymore, that I have to start something new. I didn't want to create Timo Tolkki Stratovarius. It would be like Yngwie Malmsteen's Rising Force, and I didn't want that because everybody knows the history of Stratovarius.
Right. But you are the history of Stratovarius, though.
I know. Sorry. It's my mother.
Tell her to come on the podcast.
She doesn't speak English.
We'll teach her.
She's 74.
74. Is she staying home, I hope? How is Finland dealing with the coronavirus thing?
Well, I was just talking to my mother, and if people above 70 cannot leave the house.
Right. It's kind of how it is here.
Yeah, everything is closed.
Yeah. Is it bad there at all, or is it, you know, kind of
it's
not really
that,
there?
It's not that bad. It's like, but they are like in alert.
Alexis wants to know, what school do you recommend more for classical music studies? Sibelius or Helsinki Conservatory?
What?
I don't know.
Yeah, tell me again. Tell me again.
I think you can read this on the screen. I just figured this out. Can you read that?
What school do you recommend more classical music? Sibelius.
There you go.
Yes.
Sibelius.
It's called Sibelius Academy, and anybody can...
Huh? What?
Password.
You finally. Oh.
This is a Yahoo account.
You are a Yahoo. I'm working with a Yahoo right now.
Well, I closed the email because I get these notifications too. Cancel? Hey, Timo, what's your password? Timo, old chap. Yeah, it's Sibelius Academy, and you can go there. Anybody can apply. It's a really great place. My guitar tech, Santtu, went through that, and he is like a Bachelor of Arts.
Interesting. Very good. Yeah. Go to school. Don't be a fool.
Go to school. Don't be a fool. School's out.
School's out. School's out for summer.
Yeah.
All right. Some questions. You ready?
Yes.
These are emails now. This is from our buddy Francesco, who is in Italy right now, and we wish him well.
Yes. Stay safe.
Yes, stay safe. His question is, he did read your book, Loneliness of a Thousand Years.
During the
recording sessions of the Black Album, you had an E.T. puppet in your studio at some point.
Yeah.
E.T. started talking and even a surprised Cody Pelto noticed that.
Yeah.
Please tell us about this haunted speaking E.T. You still have it somewhere?
No, it was stolen. I had it also when I had Studio Tolkki, but it was like always there, and it was speaking by itself.
What like, was the voice?
It's complete. You can buy in the States. It's a genuine ET.
Oh, so it was really talking.
Yes, it said ET phone home. ET loves you, and all these things. And he was talking about himself, like just by himself. It freaked everybody out.
I could imagine.
Yeah.
Why did you get the ET? Are you a fan of ET?
Yes, big fan.
Yeah.
I am ET, man. And it's like...
ouch. Elliot.
Elliot! So I am from Play A Dance. On the star system.
That I believe.
Yeah, I'm from there. We love you, humans. We love you, humans, but you all fucked it up, man.
Neiman asks, he writes a lot of questions sometimes. What is the order of the recording process? Who records first? The drums, the guitar, the keyboard, or the vocals last? Is it no one can escape their destiny or no one can escape their destiny?
No one can escape their destinies. I think
no one can escape their destinies.
Yeah. I mean, normally we always did like we played the song live. So everybody was playing and Timo was singing. And then everything was erased except the drums. Hmm. So we had a click track when we played the whole song together. To get the live feel.
Oh, really?
But with Black Album, it was only drums to the click. But normally, the whole band played the song. That was what I insisted as a producer.
Hmm. Was Jordan Michael bored with the drums on the Black Album?
He was pissed off.
Yeah, I can imagine he would be. No double bass on that one.
Everybody can watch the... It's called Stratovarius Mini Rockumentary in the YouTube.
All right, well,
with it, the E.T. is there, very prominent.
I don't know what this person's thing is, but I think he wrote before. Len Hiffs? I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just a name. I don't know. Which of the band members were you closer to? And who was each other's best buds? For instance, who was Colty's or Jens' best bud?
Well, Jens Johansson was my best bud.
Yeah.
I think Jörg and Jens were okay. Koti Pelto was with Kainulainen. Koti Pelto was okay with everybody. He is like that. Hmm. He's a good guy. And we were very good. I mean, we were fucking, it was like magic since this episode, this lineup. It was really a match made in heaven.
Yeah, you were together for a long time, so.
11 years.
Yeah.
It's obvious from the records. I mean, it was a match made in heaven.
Yeah. When was the last time you talked to Cody Pelto?
A couple of months ago. I tried to call him to his birthday in his WhatsApp, but he didn't answer.
Catalina. You know Catalina, right?
Cata Mejia.
Yep.
She's from Medellin, Colombia.
Yep.
Hello.
Yep, she says, hello. I hope you're doing great. This is Cara.
Yeah.
Mejia from Colombia.
Mejia.
Mejia.
Yeah. Mejia.
Mejia.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did I do good?
Yeah.
All right. Her question is to her dear and beloved Pedro Ramirez. Pedro Ramirez. Holy shit. I need a drink. Pedro Ramirez. What message would you give to your fans to stay positive and calm when everything seems to be pretty fucked up? Any book that you would recommend during this quarantine?
Is it a quarantine?
Is what?
Is it a quarantine?
Not well. Italy might be in quarantine, right?
We don't have quarantine in Mexico.
You don't, but maybe they do in Colombia. I don't know.
They have actually. I mean, if you enter Colombia as a tourist, you have to stay in isolation for 14 days.
Right.
In a hotel, whatever, wherever you are. And the local people, maybe also. I know because I have some friends there. Mm. Especially this Lily girl.
Oh.
But in Mexico, no. So I go, I had a date yesterday. So.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
That's nice.
She asked me to blow you a kiss on her behalf.
Thank you.
Did that look gay? Because she asked me if that.
Yeah, she's a great person. I talked to her in WhatsApp since fucking 6 months.
Really? Yeah. And she sends me messages every once in a while. Oh, it's always for you, though.
She's a secretary.
Oh, really?
And she tried really heavily to book me to Colombia, but of course, then this shit happened. So.
Stopped everybody.
Yeah, but it will not stop us. And my message to everybody is don't believe everything what you've been told.
Right. Some of it's been a little too much.
Use your rational logic, especially here in Mexico. It's 117 million people in this country, 316 cases, two dead.
Yeah. Mango said, yes, in Colombia there is a quarantine.
Mengele.
Mango.
Mengele. Joseph, as he's there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there. I know there's a good Mango Biche. Yes, in Colombia, there is a quarantine. Okay. Good to know, Mango.
Mango.
Mango Biche.
I like this thing. It is pretty cool, right?
Yeah. It's fun. It's very cool. Especially like with, having... with a coffee inducted. Sorry, Mac.
I had another email from this guy. He wants to do like a he wants to cover some Stratovarius songs, and he asked me, and I would, you know, do some drums with him. I just had not have the time to do this.
Yeah.
But he did have some questions to ask you. He wants to know if you could put for if can you ask Timo Tolkki could put Fourth Dimension album demo with his vocals on YouTube or some. Can you put the Fourth Dimension demo on YouTube?
No. Okay. And I have a very good reason for that.
Why? What is it?
I don't have it.
You should have known that already.
Yeah.
Who would have?
I don't have any demo. Somebody has, for sure.
So somebody has it?
Yes.
All right. And he wants you to listen to this. Hold on. There is a song. No. Can you hear that?
I hear nothing.
Okay, good. All right. We're going to watch a video here. This is really not a video. How do I add? See, my friend does this all the time.
It's really interactive.
Yeah, it is. See, I could do this. I could do that. I could just do that.
Can you do phases? Like?
Yeah, sure. How do I add a video?
StreamYard, man.
There's a way to watch a video on here because my friend does it all the time.
By the way, can you use this like WhatsApp? Can you do this with your friend?
Actually, yeah, you can. You don't have to broadcast it.
Okay.
So you can use it.
Okay.
Private chat settings. Ah, shit. I don't know how to add a damn video in here.
Really? Then we cannot watch Maniac Dance.
I will find out.
Call to the customer service.
Yeah, I'm going to look it up. And StreamYard. Talk to your fans here. Give them a story.
Is it American?
It's everybody. The world is watching you.
Illuminati.
Yes. Anything interesting? What's been going on lately? Like, what have you been doing?
Lessons, music.
Have you found any cool guitar players while you've been giving lessons, or have?
No, I haven't. I never find any cool guitar players, and I hate giving lessons.
So, you hate giving lessons?
Yes.
Have you came across any really bad guitar players?
Yes.
And do you tell them just don't even bother?
No, I don't tell them, but I try to teach them. But there was one guy in Mexico City came to me, and he couldn't even tune his guitar.
Really?
Yeah. And he had, like, his strings were old, 10 years old, and the strings were, like, so low. Like, it wasn't in tune. Really? So I tried to tune it, and then, fah, it broke the strings. I mean, most of the people just want to see me play here. So they pay 1,000 pesos, which is like $50. Can you play Stratovarius? I hate that song.
Why do you hate that song?
Because I fucking hate it.
Why?
I don't know why. It's like Axl Rose hates Paradise City. Slash hates Paradise City.
Well, you have to, because that song's like so overplayed right now.
Well... I mean, I played Stratosphere like fucking 5,000 times, so of course you get bored.
Not too many people have heard that. That's not a mainstream song.
Oh, you know what I'm saying?
No, not really. If you think about it. In the big scheme of things, no. Nobody even knows who Stratovarius is. Did you ever think of that?
Everybody knows who Stratovarius is.
A lot of people don't even know who you are. Do you realize
now they know. This is my personal message to the world.
Marcel, yes, I do have some Funko Pops in the back. I have the new Iron Maiden ones, and I have a wrestling one back there. You have to create a Funko. Oh, that would be a good idea.
What?
A Pop Timo. You know what a Funko Pop is?
No.
You don't know what the Funko Pops are?
No.
Can you see those behind me?
Yeah.
Yeah, those things.
See these?
Oh, let me get one. You got to know what these things are. They're so popular.
I don't.
Hold on.
I don't know.
Make me get up. Like this.
I've never seen those.
You had to have seen these things.
No. What the fuck should I do?
They're very popular. I'm surprised you don't have one.
What should I do with those?
See? Look how cool these things are.
Oh, it's what is that? It's Maiden?
Yeah, it's Eddie. Oh.
Well, good for him.
It is good for him. They're making a lot of money right now.
Not only right now.
They've always been making money. God damn it, I can't figure out how to do this. Share screen. No, that's not what I want to do.
Leave studio.
Nope, don't want to leave studio.
Having issues.
Description. Nope. I can just text my friend. Let's see.
Live comments.
Sorry for the delay, everybody. Don't you have any fun stories to tell people?
Yes, I always have.
All right, so tell something. Occupy these people.
I make a public comment first.
What's that?
You can add comments, I see.
Let's see.
Here are the live comments.
Yeah.
Yeah, I will have a Skype lesson with this guy.
This guy?
Andrew Marquez.
To do what?
Guitar.
Oh. I hope you know how to play, Andrew.
He paid for it too.
Oh my god. How much are we charging? Can we say how much you're charging?
I charge for this guy $200.
What a bargain.
I don't sell my skeet easily, man.
I don't blame you. How long is the lesson for?
Whatever. It doesn't have time.
There's no ending time?
No.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That is a good deal then.
It's a good deal, yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, sometimes I make it 150, but it really varies.
All right.
But it's always in advance by Western Union.
Interesting.
Because I hate PayPal.
Everybody does.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know how to do this. Yeah, I don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
When I figure this out, I think we will do this cool thing and to watch a video. It'll be kind of fun because then you can make fun of your videos and stuff. Hey, Andrew wants to know if he can play some of your solos.
But is it a question or a statement?
He says, I don't know. He says, I can play some of your solos, or can I play some of your solos?
Well, to the first question, I don't know. to the second one, yes.
I hope that's not a real picture of you, Andrew.
How do I know if he can play my solos? Because I never met this guy.
And do you even know your own solos, or are they just kind of like ad-libbed? He said it's a statement. Oh, shit. He said he can play your solos.
Oh, good for him. Good that somebody can. I mean, almost all my solos are improvised in the studio.
Right.
Yeah. So, like Speed of Light, I wrote the passages, but mostly it's improvised. And then I just set up the time between the start of the end of the solo, and I played until I found something interesting. I recorded it, and then when the time came to do a tour, I had to fucking learn the solo.
Right.
Which was not always easy.
Don't remember a lot of things that you do?
Now, yes. I mean, 3,000 shows in 52 countries. It's like, I know how to play them.
When you play out, how do you pick a set list?
Well, it varies, but now in here in Latin America, I try to make some new stuff, like from Avalon, like especially from the first Avalon.
Is that your favorite one, the first Avalon?
Well, I like it all. I think it's the best one, the first. So
no.
I'm really heavily into Within Temptation's Silent Force album. So I'm gonna write some symphonic stuff for the next Avalon, I think.
That would be a good idea.
I think it's a good idea. I think it sort of makes sense because now I have great amp, I have great, and I have an Ibanez now. And the acoustic guitar. Yeah. Some friend.
Well, don't let ESP know that.
Yeah, but I will get an ESP. But now, because I need a guitar, so I really am practicing heavily every day, hours again, because I want to be the best.
You already are the best.
I am not, but I will again.
Marcel wants to know, have you thought about using the Richie Blackmore signature heads again?
Well, I have it in Finland.
All right.
I have this head in Finland. So, yes, I have been thinking.
Yep.
But I have a deal with, it's like Peruvian label called Cordova, like great, like tube amps. So I have my signature with the Tolkki logo, and it's purple. Whole fucking amp and a cabinet too with my logo.
Nice. So you didn't smash that one?
But I never saw it yet. I'm gonna get it one of these days.
I hope so.
You see, here in Monterey, I can actually rent the whole fucking house, like three rooms and a kitchen, for like $200 a month.
That's insane.
$200 a month, man.
That's like free.
Yeah. But I also have a flat in Prague, but I cannot enter Prague as well. And I have a job. I have a job in Mexico City. I'm in Monterey, and I have a flat in Prague. I cannot go to Finland, so I don't know what's going to happen.
Anything can happen. What about you singing again? What's going on with that?
My singing?
Yeah.
Well, I can still do it. So.
Sort of. I heard you sing not too long ago.
Where?
It's a little rough. Karaoke.
Yeah, that's a stupid yeah. Well, that was in Mexico City. I think.
I don't know, you were singing all over the place. But have you, do you think you're ever going to sing on an album again or what?
I would like to do Him to Life too.
I would like you to do that too.
You know, because I wrote all the songs for Him to Life on Infinite Tour.
Yeah.
Because there's always like 12 hours, nothing to do. So you wake up like 10 in the morning in the fucking bus. And the sound check is like 8, but we never did sound checks with Stratovarius because we had so good crew. So we thought, fuck it. So I had like 12 hours before the show. So I booked a hotel room for every city. I took my recording equipment to the room and I wrote the fucking hymn to life on the road.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. And then I returned to Finland. I went to this summer cottage where I recorded. And the song Hymn to Life has like real wind in the trees. I put two mics outside. And in exactly the right moment, you feel like birds. They are really live birds on the song. It's not a sample. It's a real forest.
Really?
Yes.
That's good.
In the Chaplin song. So
I haven't listened to that album in a while.
That's one of the most dearest albums for me.
It is one of my favorite albums.
Yeah.
I do like that album a lot.
Yeah, it is. And now it's going to be on Spotify so I can listen myself. Because I hate the fucking YouTube.
All right, here. Use the share screen. He's telling me how to do it here. Application, Chrome tab, and your entire screen, application window. Oh, here we go.
We can see the video?
I can get the video. Let's see. Well, this one is something that somebody wanted me to show to you. Let's see if this works. All right. Can you see this on the screen now?
Yes.
All right.
Sort of.
It says, most mysterious song on the internet. He wants to know if you've heard this song before.
I don't see anything.
Well, can you hear anything?
Yes, but it's not very loud.
Oh, how about this? Is that better?
Yes.
Apparently, this song. Let me hold on a minute. This guy thinks that there's many doubts that this would be from Finland. He says, and Timo Tolkki was making music already in the 80s. Apparently nobody knows who this song is. It's just some mysterious song on the internet.
Well, it sounds fucking horrible, whatever it is.
You don't like it?
No.
I think it's kind of catchy.
It sucks.
It sounds like Ghost. Do you like Ghost?
I don't know what is Ghost.
You don't know what Ghost is?
I know what is the Ghost is in Paranormal, but not in the band.
Ghost? You don't know
what the band is? Look, you look like an idiot in the screenshot.
Nice. You look like an idiot.
I always look like an idiot.
You don't know what Ghost is?
No.
Really?
Really. Look at you.
I look like I'm hungry. Let me put a Ghost on. You've never heard of Ghost. That kind of blows my mind.
I have never heard.
So I'm introducing you to Ghost right now.
Thank you.
This is one of my favorite newer bands.
I need 7 seconds to say if I like it or not.
Okay, let's do that. Let's sit through this commercial. All right. Here's Ghost.
Can I make it louder?
Let's see here. Oops, sorry. Is that better?
Sort of. That's better.
I'm surprised you've never heard this.
Well, it's nothing like amazing. I think they suck.
Listen to the chorus, man.
There is no chorus.
No good?
I don't like it.
You don't like it?
No. It's not melodic.
Not melodic? What the hell are you talking about?
It sucks. They should go. They should stop.
You're insane.
No, I'm not insane. Everybody else is insane.
All right. Now that I figured this out, you want to watch Maniac Dance?
Yes.
All right, let's go. Maniac Dance, full screen, full volume. Here we go. Now, you said you got a story to tell about this, right?
Yeah, it's the director. It's called Antti Jokinen, and he was like very famous and is very famous director in Finland. He, for example, directed Shania Twain's Ka-Ching.
Okay.
The song. And he did some movie with Hilary Swank.
All right.
He's very famous.
Now, where'd you film this?
It's some factory in Helsinki. They did like two sets. There's this girl in the living room, and then we are in this factory hall.
I got to turn this down because nobody can hear you. And then we'll probably get flagged on YouTube, too, for playing music. So if anybody wants to watch the video along with the music, play it yourself and watch along. So what else can you tell us about this video? Where did these cars come from? Is that from like a movie or something, or did they have this specially filmed for this thing?
No, he had a lot of stuff for this, some, you know, stuff. And it was cut in L.A.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Who's the girl, do you know?
It's one model.
Who?
Some model in Helsinki.
Oh. Did she do other videos too?
No, this guy?
No, he did, the girl.
No, I don't know that, but this Antti Jokinen who directed this, he did Night with Nemo.
Oh, really?
Yes. He did, and he did also Amaranthi of Nightwish.
Okay.
Yes. And this was like, my idea was to have it in black and white, but he made like a blue tint, kind of bluish.
Yeah.
And I told him I want to use a lot of like close-ups.
Right.
So I think it's a good video. I think it is good.
It's not bad, but it's making me dizzy because it's cutting back to...
Yeah, he did a lot of cuts.
I haven't seen you once in this whole video. Is that purposely done?
I hope. I'm there.
Yeah, you're there, Luke. Somewhere.
Yeah. Somewhere over the rainbow. Let's see. It's me. You recognize?
There you are. A little bit.
That's like 14 years, 15 years ago.
That's insane. What do you think about when you see yourself in these old videos? Do you remember doing these videos? Like,
yeah, I do remember everything. Yeah. I remember everything since I was born.
Yeah.
Yes. I have a very long memory, man.
I don't think I've ever seen this video.
Yeah, I think it's a good one.
What's your favorite video that you've done so far?
Must be Hunting High and Low.
Yeah, okay.
I think it is, definitely.
That's the one where you're all getting, everybody was wet, right? Getting rained on?
You know, my idea was to do it in a swimming pool.
Right.
Put the drum kit to the swimming pool and then raise it up. But it was impossible to make. So the director made this kind of a pool with like this 2 inches, 3 inches of water and right. Cold. So everybody got flu. We got 8 hours in fucking water and splashing. And Timo fell down at one point. You can see it in the video. And I destroyed a keyboard. I dropped the keyboard to the water.
Nice.
Yes. So Hunting High and Low is my favorite. When this was filmed, we couldn't be there. He told us, go out.
When they filmed all this other stuff?
The girly stuff, yeah.
Oh, why?
I don't know. Couldn't be there.
Huh. Was it because she was naked?
I think so. I mean, she's not bad looking, so.
No.
That's why. I think he thought everybody want to fuck her or something. Which is true.
I was just going to say, seeing that you have like a woman in every state now, every country.
I don't have, no. I don't have.
That's not what I heard.
Well, don't believe everything you hear about me. You know better than that.
Yes, I know. I'm only kidding.
You know, the sailors, they have women in every port.
That is true. Interesting video. Now, how do I stop sharing that? Stop sharing. Oh, there we go. That wasn't too bad.
Yeah, that's good.
A cool video. I wish we could hear the sound.
I have to send you this JFK documentary, which is like saying that there were 8 teams in Dealey Plaza.
There were what?
8 shooting teams in Dealey Plaza.
Oh, I've heard a lot about that. That, I don't know. That's well, I don't think we'll ever really know.
They even name the shooters, and they even say how much money they got each.
Really?
$50,000 each. And they say where the headshot came, it came from the manhole below.
Right.
His head goes like this.
Right.
It couldn't come from up or here because it goes like this. So it came from below.
Right.
From the manhole.
I've heard that a lot.
Yeah.
I don't think we really ever find the answer to that.
Of course not, because it was George Bush Sr. behind it.
It was what?
George Bush Sr. and Richard Nixon were behind it.
Yeah. Hey, man, Marcel's got a lot of questions. There is no formal proposal to make Algon with Stratovarius. Like, what is what?
A fucking Algon.
What's that mean?
I think he's using Traductor, the Google Translator.
Oh.
Yeah. He looks like an interesting guy.
Yeah, he's kind of just.
It's like a pink. I guess it means if we're going to do like a Strato United.
No, I don't think that's. Oh, yes, maybe that's what that means. Yes.
Because
yes,
Halloween.
We've talked about that plenty of times.
Come on, guys. Watch the fucking podcast.
I know. We're on 14 episodes, and he's said this about numerous times.
Come on, man.
Come on, Marcel. Fuck. Yeah.
Come on.
Come on, Marcel. You want to come back on the show?
Block him.
Come on. No, I kicked him out, but he can come back on if he wants.
Is Claudia still following the podcast?
Oh, I have no idea.
Yeah.
She friended me, though.
Did she?
Yeah.
Where?
On Facebook. They say don't bite your nails.
If you tell me don't, I have to.
Yes. He's like a child. You can't tell him not to do something. Pablo wants to know what your favorite album is.
Well, before I answer that, he just spell my name correctly.
Let's see.
Another question.
Nope. What's your favorite? Nope. We did it wrong twice.
I'm not Tolkki.
Pablo again. A very different Stratovarius than Ghost. Yes. Timo did not like Ghost. I don't know how you didn't like Ghost. I think you're insane. I think you better listen to him a little bit more.
Okay. I will. I promise. Yes, it was scalloped.
How long?
What does he mean? That ESP? I mean, I had 14 of them.
I don't know.
How am I supposed to know what is that?
I don't know. Marcel, explain yourself. What that ESP are you talking about? And Pablo again misspelled your name, but then asked how long Tolkki is going to be living in Mexico.
How long Tolkki is going to be? Tolkki is gunning. I don't know how long Tolkki is gunning to live in Mexico because Tolkki doesn't know where to rent the bread that I don't tell how to look at.
You're going to end up owning Mexico by the time you leave.
I'm going to be the president of Mexico.
You might be.
But like his mustache, like mariachi shit.
Did you ever see the picture I made of you with the hat?
It's fucking good. I love it. So fucking cool. I was like, you know, how long Tolkki is going to live in Mexico? I have no answer because I have a flat in Prague. I maybe have a flat in Monterrey, probably. And I have a job in Mexico City. I sent you an email today, Timo. Greetings.
Oh, he did that all correct.
Timo. Okay, that's good. Not Timo.
And Marcel, guys, I do what I can. Blame Google.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Timo Sanchez.
That's a new one. I'm Pedro Ramirez.
I can say Timo Sanchez a lot easier than Pedro Ramirez.
Sanchez.
Timo Sanchez kind of flows off the tongue. I like that one.
You know how they say that the deer child has many names?
That is true. whatever that meant. I don't know what this means.
Timoteo in Mexico. Rafael Gonzalez. Why do I get all these hairy Mexican guys? Why not any girls?
Yeah, I don't think there's any girls. And this could be a girl. I mean, there's a picture of a flower there.
So that's a fucking Russian.
Oh, yeah, well, you never know. I don't know.
I know from the letters. It's a Russian.
No, I know it's a Russian.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it's a man or a woman or what.
Woman.
All right, guys. Any questions before we head on out of here? We did an hour and a half. Holy shit.
Really?
Yes, we did.
I have still 20% of battery, so we can continue.
I got to get upstairs. I told my wife I'd be only an hour.
Well, I think I can. If I can sum it up, the Black Album was like the end of the band.
Well, no shit.
Yeah, no shit. Because Jörg Michael told me in America that this is over.
It is over.
He told me this is over. And so I thought, okay, this is over and let it be over. But we still tried with Revolution Renaissance, and there exist the demos on the net of the whole album. So there is two versions. There is Stratovarius Revolution Renaissance and Revolution Renaissance.
Wait. Oh, so there is two. Okay, I got you.
We got the demos. We made the demos.
Now, what happened with the demos? Who has them?
Jens.
We know you don't.
Jens put them on the net.
Oh, we did?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
We're going to have to get him to put them back on the net because I'm sure they're gone.
We should get Jens online.
I was just going to say, why don't we get him online?
Well, I emailed him and I have his number too, but he never answers.
Unbelievable.
I talk to Anders a lot though.
Yeah. We'll get him on the show too.
Or Joey DeMaio.
And Joey DeMaio is not going to do the show.
Are you sure?
We could try.
Yeah.
He lives where I live, so, you know. We do have something in common.
But he lives in Brooklyn.
All right, so that's only like maybe 45 minutes away. Not that long.
Yeah. I can ask him.
Ask him.
Okay.
Get Jens to come on too. He's always on Facebook. He's always writing shit on Facebook. And nobody's doing anything now. No, all tours are canceled.
Yeah.
So there's no excuse for anybody not to come on this show.
Yeah, let's do a fucking show.
Actually, you know who I got to contact again is Alex Holdsworth because he was supposed to come on the show. What's going on with that anyway? What's going on with the whole new album?
With Infinite Visions.
Yeah.
We're making demos. And we have five. My manager is writing a lot of lyrics.
Your manager is writing lyrics?
It's like ABBA. ABBA had the manager who wrote lyrics.
How come you're not writing the lyrics?
Because I'm too lazy.
Jesus Christ.
It's a demo, so I'm going to write the lyrics later. But...
Do you have a guitar right there? Pablo wants you to play guitar.
It's upstairs.
Go get it. Play us a little song on your way out.
But it's I don't have an amp down here.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, I get it.
We can still hear it.
Wait. Should I?
Go ahead.
It's difficult to play here.
It doesn't matter. Nobody cares.
I get it.
Nobody's watching this anyway. Only 13 people. Thanks, Pablo. What else? What can we watch while we're waiting for Timo to come back? What's something really bad that we can watch? How about we watch Hunting High and Low? How about that? Oh, this is an ad. And again, if I put music on, I will get silenced on YouTube. So we'll just watch the video. How's that? Oh, wait. Can't watch the video because I didn't share the screen. Hold on. I'm learning this as I go. Forgive me. Here we go. Hunting High and Low, the video. Oh, look at this. Look at those wonderful graphics. His hair is flowing in the wind. Look at this guy. Who's this guy? Gotta ask Timo. When we watch this video with Timo, we gotta ask him, what the hell's going on here? Something very important on that phone. Taking him an awfully long time to get that guitar. He is totally soaked right now and pissed off, I would imagine. Don't do it. Oh, he threw all the papers all over the place. Oh my God. He doesn't give one shit. Ah, fuck are you? You threw all the papers out. Here's your new album cover. I don't like that cover.
It's like official Timo Tolkki underwear.
wait. I'm sharing the a video here. What?
Anybody who wants this,
no,
email me.
Oh my god.
They have never used, man.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it. What the hell is that on there?
I don't know, sperm. sperm. I don't know. It doesn't look like sperm.
Marcel wants to know if you could touch a drop in the ocean. A drop in the ocean. Can you touch a drop in the ocean?
Yeah.
I don't know if you could touch a drop in the ocean. Should we have somebody come in and sing the song with you while you're playing the guitar?
It's out of tune. Fucking Freud Rose. But I can't play this shit. I'm like, fuck. Not fucking Tits of Judas, no fucking Hunting High and Low, no fucking Stratovarius. Fuck the Stratovarius. No, sorry. No, but with this guitar, I'm like writing the new Avalon, so it's like a Ibanez. Nice. I shouldn't show this because I'm signed to ESP, so.
Yeah, you shouldn't have. Now you're going to be
deleted.
Hey, you might have Ibanez send you guitars next.
Somebody says I should have an auction for my underwear.
You should.
Where?
Right here. Sell it at an auction.
Where?
On eBay.
How did I do that?
You don't know how to do eBay?
No.
Well, I'm not doing it. I know how to do eBay. I'm not selling your underwear on eBay.
I can sell it in Facebook, right?
You could. Actually, you could.
Yeah.
You could do a live feed on Facebook and then start an auction. Last night on Earth.
I hope not.
The underwear. Is China the Ibanez? That was the Ibanez Chinese. What is that?
Oh, it's Marco Polo.
Why would you bring that down with you?
I wanted to show. This is my wallet. It's full of money. Pesos, man.
Wow. Nice.
And I'm going to show the other one, but the...
Nice. Well, don't do that. Jesus Christ. This is live right now. I can't block that. Somebody's going to pull up the video.
Who is she?
I have no idea. Who is she?
She's from Mexico City. She's like a bass player. She's pretty known there.
Hmm. What is that, her business card?
Yes. What else do I have in here?
Sell as your underwear as part of a VIP package at your shows. Used, of course.
What fucking shows?
That's true.
I think this is from Prague.
Yeah.
I will show everything what I have here.
All right.
This good. Is my Finnish. It's like a health insurance card.
Don't show any numbers.
Finland. No, it's nothing in secret. It's just my name and my social security number.
No, that doesn't mean anything.
The fuck is this? This is a bus card for Helsinki.
A bus card?
Yeah. Doesn't do much in Mexico, though.
No, I wouldn't think so.
And I lost my driver's license.
You could drive? You were driving a car the other day.
I was not driving a car.
Were you waxing the car?
Yeah, it's my new car.
Is that how you make money now? You wax cars?
I didn't wax the car.
Where is it? Timo Tapioca. That's a good one too.
Ha ha ha. Very funny. This Martin is kind of a funny guy.
He's funny.
Where is it? I had a really nice receipt from the restaurant because the bill in Mexico was like 666 pesos.
Really?
Yeah.
Which comes out to what in like American money? Like
six,
10 bucks?
666.
Yeah.
It's like.
Currency. It's not much.
666 pesos is 26 bucks.
Oh.
Yeah.
Pablo, you do not have a profile picture. It's just a gray person thing there. So we don't know what you look like.
Who is Pablo Z?
I have no idea who Pablo Z is. Timo, do you miss Helsinki?
Yes, I do. My family is there. My daughter is there. My daughter Nina just got a new flat, thanks God.
Really?
Yeah, because she was living like 6 months with friends and stuff. So It's very good for her. I'm going to do music with her because I was having all these things with all fucking Claudias and all shit, but I never realized that I have the best singer in my own family, my daughter, who is a great...
You finally realized that?
Yes, she's a great singer, so I'm going to do music with her this year.
What does she do?
She's unemployed.
No, I'm not talking about work. I'm talking about music.
She does like pop.
You can do pop?
Man, I can do anything.
Pop's easy.
Actually, because my metal career is approaching to its end, because I'm 54 and I'm going to do this.
I thought it was already. Wait, you're going to switch to pop now?
I'm gonna like start writing pop songs and like really like dance and pop songs. Because that's where the big money is.
And this is the end of the Timo Tolkki podcast. We don't know a pop music Timo Tolkki. We refuse to have pop music.
Well, Him to Life is pop. Sana is pop.
Not really.
Sana has no guitars.
I guess. I don't know.
There is no guitars.
I don't want to talk about Sana yet.
What is the next album we talk about?
We're going to go about your solo albums.
Okay, what's the first? Classical?
Classical, yeah.
Okay.
And then we'll do Him to Life, and then...
Do we do live as well?
Yeah.
I think it's very good.
Yeah, it's been fun doing it live, so yeah.
I don't like the Skypey.
Yeah, no, Skype's a pain in the ass.
Skypey.
Anything black metal? You don't like black metal, right?
These guys are like... Do they talk to their mothers like that? You know, my daughter was a very big fan of Cradle of Filth.
Right.
I spent 1.5 years hearing this fucking death mass through the door. And I opened the door and there was like a kingdom of Satan with like black candles and black curtains and shit. And like, it's like, then she loves the guy. So I arranged a meeting with Danny Field in Helsinki. So we went to see, and there is this guy who is like 130 centimeters long. and my daughter is 172. So like, this is the guy you adore?
Right.
But she met him, and he was nice, I have to say. So
why is she doing more pop metal stuff and not metal?
Because she's grown up now.
Yeah. She's not into metal anymore?
Well, she is, but she has Tolkki genes. And she has my eyes.
Yeah. So
we're going to do like very commercial pop album with her in Finnish.
What's your favorite pop band? I like pop music too.
Shania Twain.
That's country music, isn't it?
No, when he did this Red album and From This Moment, the song and those are not.
No, that is pop. I'm thinking of somebody different. Sorry.
No, she started in Tennessee as a country, you know.
Oh, she did. All right. So I was right. Marcel
Pierce. I like Britney. I mean, my biggest idol in producing is Max Martin, this American guy from LA. But he's not American, he's Swedish.
Yeah.
You know.
We just talked about your new album. What are you talking about, Marcel? We just asked.
Well, we are here to serve. So he means Infinite Visions.
Yeah, we were just talking about that.
It's like 12 songs. They are ready, and we are doing songs for 5 demos. And my new website is going to be up in 1 week. And we're going to put 1 demo when I mix it, downloadable for free.
Good, I hope so. You were supposed to send me the demos. And I was going to leak them all over the internet. But I would never do that. Never. Yeah.
Well, I will send them to you.
Yes, do that, please. Yeah. I like to hear. So it's I can like, give my critique. I'll tell
it's
you.
Like 12 songs. And yeah, it's going to be very good album, actually. It's the songs are melodic. They are power metal, but also pop metal, Hunting High and Lowish. It's very much like Infinity. Mm. And the Avalon, I still don't know, but I know it's going to be more symphonic.
Why'd you call it Infinite Visions? Because
I don't know.
It sounds like those two albums, or just a cool name?
It's a cool name.
Yeah. Well, even, you know, if you name something like that, people are going to assume it sounds like those two albums.
Yeah, man. I've been into marketing before.
But if it doesn't, then people are going to be upset. So, you know.
Well, they're all going to be always going to be upset. They're never satisfied because they want their Black Diamonds. They want their Hunting High and Lows. They want their Eagle Hearts, Beetle Farts, Tits of Judases, whatever. Fuck. I mean, what I do is I write my songs, okay? I don't try to please anyone except myself. And in the end, if somebody likes the songs, that's very nice. And I respect that and I feel it's good. But I have never done anything to please anyone. Mm. Not as a person, not in music.
Nah. Any plans to do a festival appearance in Europe?
Well, my friend, if there is going to be any festivals in Europe, that's the thing, because I heard even Wacken will be canceled.
Somebody told me there's already cancellations for July. I'm not sure what place, what that is, but yeah, July.
Yes, I know.
So,
but that's like fucking March. I mean, it's like 4 months from now. So.
Yeah. So a lot of people are really not too optimistic.
Yeah, well, I think it's going to be like, well, next year, sure. I mean, I think that my Avalon is going to come out this autumn.
Okay.
And Infinite Visions can come 4 months after that. That's the deal with Frontiers.
Yeah.
So if Avalon comes in October, Infinite Visions will come out next year in February, and the tour will be then in the spring.
Who's going to be putting out Infinite Visions? Do you have a?
Well, my manager will start shopping the deals right after we finish the demos.
Who would you like to do it?
Nuclear Blast.
Yeah.
I mean, it's almost there. You know, yeah. They just want to hear them. So, I've done the guitars. I played the bass, the solos, everything, and the Jimmy is doing the keyboards. And there's a Peruvian Jorge, the singer. Hmm. So it's not Vesquera. Sorry, Mike. No.
Sorry, Mike.
But I'm gonna do a concert tour in Japan in November with Mike.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, it's like a celebration of Infinity, 20 years of anniversary.
Very cool.
It's cool because I love the guy. He's a really cool guy. So,
how come it fell through with the album?
Will your touring band for Infinity Vision differ from the recording lineup? No, it's going to be the same.
What happened with Mike?
Well, I started out with Mike already like last year's fucking November, but I didn't have the songs because I had other things in my mind. So, one thing. Then I started composing the songs in Prague in January, and very soon it was evident to me that they are too high for him.
Right.
And that I needed somebody like Timo or Kiske. And then this Jorge guy who played with me in September in Peru. And then he called me in WhatsApp and I said, oh, it's you. I mean, you played a gig with me. Don't you remember? I don't remember. Sorry. Yeah, you're the guy who threw a beer at my face at the end of the show. Hmm. Apparently, I did like...
You threw a beer at Mike Visser?
No, to Jorge.
Oh.
I never met Mike Vesquera.
Oh, really?
Never.
So how did that whole thing come to be then?
Well, I got in touch with him via Facebook.
Oh, so you just messaged him?
Yes. Oh. You know Facebook.
I'm surprised he wrote you back because I wrote him. He didn't write me back.
He doesn't write you back?
No.
Bastard. Why not? You want him in the show?
I was gonna have him on the show, but now that he's not gonna be involved with you, forget it.
No, he's gonna be with in Japan.
No, I know, you just said that, but
yeah,
tell him to come on the show.
I will.
Fabio Leone, Timo of Fire. What happened with Frontier? Like
Rhapsody of the Magic Circle, Ancient Forest, Knights of Evil Kingdom, Rhapsody, Leone.
Gene, we have went through this Frontiers thing a long time ago. Watch the show. This is episode 14. We talked about it on like the first episode.
Well, what happened with Frontiers is that I'm apparently still signed to them. So
right.
I have an option for 2 Avalons. But my manager, I mean, 2.
It's okay, it's,
they have an option for 2 Avalons. So my manager, negotiated a deal that I can release Infinite Visions album 4 months after the Avalon.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, Frontiers is like a company which has a lot of projects, basically. They are not really interested in anything like long term, but they're just cashing out pretty much.
Right. Pablo wants you to say his name.
Pablo Zermeno Salud.
Although he couldn't pronounce your last name or spell your last name correctly.
Okay. So Pablo. Salud, Pablo Zermeno. That's for you, man. I am fucking pissed about them.
Yeah.
They, as far as I know, they can fuck off.
Are you going to put that in the thank yous? And fuck off Frontiers.
Fuck off them, because, you know, they only want to use my name. I don't know why they want the Avalon, but I have to do it because they want. Okay. They hate me and I hate them.
Will a song dedicated to Carol Gott from Infinite Visions be instrumental or lyrics?
It's instrumental song for Karel. That's the guy of my ex-wife. Father of my ex-wife.
Hmm. The ongoing topic of this show is over. We're just rambling on now. But the topic of this show was the Black Album.
Yeah.
You can watch it later.
So this is going to be on YouTube.
This is going to be on YouTube, and it will be available on a podcast, iTunes, Stitcher, Spotify. Everybody, we are everywhere. You underestimate.
Where's the money?
I want to know that too.
Yeah.
I spend money. You tell them, you kidding me? I spend money on the website. I spend money on the for the podcast thing. No, I make nothing.
It's time for some serious greenbacks for Timo, man.
Yes, for me too.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to start with these. So if somebody wants these, it's like $1,000 signed with Timo sperm.
Oh, my God.
I don't think it's sperm, though.
I hope not.
You think?
I don't know what that is.
I don't think it's sperm. If it is, there's like about a billion Timos in this. Also, I can sell the banana peels.
Do not drop that on the floor and slip on it. You know that's a challenge, right? The banana peel challenge. People are really getting hurt on that thing. If anybody watching this now, we do this every week. Oh, try to do it every week. As you can see, we're on like the 14th episode already.
How much is this worth?
We go through every album. Did somebody make that for you?
Yeah. I got it yesterday from Girl.
But all of our stuff is on YouTube. You can look up Rat Salad Review. That's the name of my normal show, but it's a Rat Salad Review Network. And all the Timo shows and all my other shows. Oops. All my other shows are on that. That's my very expensive microphone. RatSaladReview.com. Everything is on there. And you can even buy a shirt and help us out.
Help us out, please. Help us out,
please. Sorry. That's my microphone. See? Nobody can see it. It's a newer.
What microphone is that? Oh.
Yeah, it's a $15 Amazon microphone.
Okay.
I do have good ones though, somewhere around here. I got a Shure microphone, SM57.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good for like snare.
Right. Yeah. That's what I usually use it for.
We used always that for snare and toms.
Yeah. That's what I use mine for. But yeah. Now I'm actually using it for vocals.
57.
It seems to work very well.
And like Joel and Turner always used that for the.
Yeah, I was doing some research, and a lot of people use that for.
Yeah, yeah.
Too. It's they like, use it for everything. So
yeah, really. it's like 58, like without the high presence.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds pretty good so far. So
yes, it's very good.
Yep. You should know. I did send you a song that I wanted you to put the guitar solo on, but you never listened to it.
Well, it got stuck because I have like.
Yeah, I know. No, I actually sent it to you in a messenger.
I sent messenger?
Yeah. I'll send it to you again.
I have...
That was like a month ago.
9,586 emails.
Terrible. I want Timo's underwear on the cover of his next album. Not a bad idea.
Well, this guy's from France, probably. Jean-Baptiste Appert.
Yeah. Probably.
Merci beaucoup.
There were feet on the second Strato album, so why not? There was what feet were on
the Well, second? There are two times when I let a drummer or singer choose the cover, and the first was like Twilight Time. That was feet of the statue in Helsinki. That was Lassila.
Oh.
And the second time, Jean-Baptiste Appert. Je jouis papillon. So... And the next time was Episode with Kotipel. That's a fucking horrible cover. Horrible cover.
I don't think it's that
it's
bad.
It's music to my ear. Paris? Paris? Right. Paris?
You know what's music to my ear? The end of the show.
It's been 2 hours. 156, 34 and counting to the lockdown of New York.
No, we're already locked down.
You already locked down?
Yes, we've been locked down since Saturday. I have two kits. I have a Pearl kit and then I have a Mapex kit.
This guy is actually Wayne. He's a Batman.
I am Batman.
Bruce Wayne.
I am on the weekends. I am Batman.
I will
He's gonna sample that now.
Jean-Baptiste Appert. Jean-Baptiste Appert from Pedro Ramirez.
That would make a good pop song.
With love from Finland. James Tapio Tolkki. Bon.
All right. Anything else you want to talk about before we get out of here? I have to piss real bad. I didn't get up.
Yeah, you hold it. So.
I did.
We hold the pee to the door.
Oh, he wants to hear your theory about coronavirus.
You know what? We're not going to get into that. It's like 2 hours more.
Apparently, he doesn't follow you on Facebook.
Well, he can write to me into my email.
Oh, boy.
Sleep?
Write to your email. You don't read them.
I read everything. I have emails from Joey DeMaio.
I know. You've said that about 5 times. What's the big deal? It's just Joey DeMaio.
I like him. I like the Man of War.
He's funny. Get him on the show.
I try.
The best thing you could do for me, because you know I do the show for you, get me Michael Kiske.
I will try. I will try.
No, you will.
I will try.
You will.
I will. Michael. Yes, sir.
You will get me Kiske.
Oh, you do Kiske. Mike.
Yes, get him. He's not doing anything. They got to be done with the album by now, right?
They're done, yeah.
Yeah, so
they're done.
There you go.
Are they going to be touring in the autumn? I think.
Nobody's touring.
In the autumn, I think October for sure.
Yeah, it'll start again. Have you heard any samples of that yet?
I don't know.
No?
Nobody. They're very secretive.
I can imagine.
He just told me that everybody wrote songs for the album.
Oh, good. Yes. I hope it's good.
I think it will be good.
You think so?
Kai Hansen asked me to join Unisonic.
Kai Hansen, didn't he leave Unisonic, though?
That's why, Timo, you can replace me.
Do you think that you could do that?
No, because if I do Unisonic, what can I do with my solo career? It's bon voyage, Timito.
No, not necessarily. They made it work for themselves, so why not?
That's true. Well, then I could at least finally meet Kiske.
You can finally meet Kiske. Yeah. And Dennis Ward, he's a good guy. You ever meet him?
Yes, I met him. Yeah, he's a very good guy.
Yeah, very good bass player.
Yes, and producer. So we have a mutual respect. Me and Dennis, he loves my stuff, and I love his stuff.
Yeah, he does a lot of good stuff. I didn't know he just joined Magnum. Are you a fan of Magnum?
No.
No.
No, I'm not.
You miss us, admitted. Do you know this gene?
What's us?
I don't know.
Define us.
I don't know. I don't know what that means.
The French people.
Do you miss them?
I miss the playing in Le Zenith. For 6,500 people with Symphony X. Of course I miss.
Of course. I've never been there. I wouldn't know.
I like Paris. I like France. I like Toulouse. I like Lyon. I like the country. They have a very good red wine.
I wouldn't know. I don't drink wine.
You should. We've been drinking every day here, and everybody's like worried about me. Like what I eat, what I drink. They like write to my Facebook like, you're not supposed to eat that. But I say, yeah, Zenith, exactly. 99 and, yeah, Elements. The best years.
You do have to eat, you have to live.
Exactly, and drink. So we're going to get smashed again tonight.
Hey, you're doing all right, though. There was a while where you did have a little bit of an issue with the drinking, but you're doing better now. So
yes,
I think it's okay.
I never had an issue with the drinking. The drinking had an issue with me.
Right, right. No, but when we first started this, I didn't know what the hell was going to happen.
Well, I made it through, so I'm here in Mexico.
You're here. That's all that matters. No France, no wine, sad. And I'm sorry. I'm a very boring person.
He's not in front. Oh, okay.
No, he's talking about me. Because I've never been to France. I don't drink wine. My wife drinks wine.
Yeah. My wife, we should get your wife to the show.
She does not. She don't even know who you are.
Everybody knows who I am.
My wife has no idea who you are.
Come on, play her some music. I'm very romantic. She will love it.
She will not like it.
No?
No.
What does she like?
She likes like singer songwriter kind of stuff, like
Tell Him to Life.
No, she wouldn't like that either.
I think I have a special song for her, Father.
No, I think she would like that either. How much did Derek Riggs take for the Infinite cover?
$4,000.
Yeah. Damn, I could have got that done for you like half price.
With Riggs, man.
Doesn't matter.
Still he did the Elements too.
And he did and
Him to Life.
Yeah.
Yes. And he was a very funny guy. I remember that.
What's so funny
about Derek Riggs? He was just very humoristic and comical. Because I asked him a lot about the Maiden stuff, and he said that it's all painted. It's not computer stuff like Infinity. It's like, also painted.
Yeah, that's what bothered me. Like after they made and got rid of him, and then they had that one guy do, I think it was Dance of Death.
Yes,
and they did it all digital, and it was like, I mean, Eddie looked cool, but the people around him looked so stupid. It just was dumb.
He did a lot of work for Him to Life. The hands, you know.
Oh, Timo, just an idea. Since you will be confined in no time in Mexico, do you live? Do a live from your place, acoustic.
What is confined?
Confined. You'll be stuck in your house or your apartment or wherever.
I don't think so. There is no quarantine order here.
Not yet. It's going to be soon.
No. Not in Mexico.
They said it's not going to be bad here for another month. So figure about Mexico.
Well, basically the Mexican president refuses that.
No. They all do until it hits.
He vetoes about that.
He vetoes the coronavirus?
He vetoes not to have a quarantine.
And don't make people pay to watch it. I will be broke anyway because I am buying your underwear.
He's going to buy my underwear?
He might. I don't know.
I have a lot of stuff to sell, actually.
I'm sure you do.
So you suggest an eBay auction?
You could do eBay, yeah. Or can I do a Facebook Live and auction it on Facebook?
How do they pay in eBay? Do they pay cash?
You can get a money order, but usually people use PayPal, which you hate.
Then no eBay.
Yeah. How else can you get money from eBay? I think PayPal and a money order, and that's it.
What is money order?
It's like it's kind of like a check. You go to like the post office or a bank or whatever, and you just have them, okay. You give them the cash, and then they give you like this little check looking thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And don't make people
again.
No, I was my mistake. Yeah. Here in Argentina, we are in quarantine, as in Mexico, not yet.
No,
nope. At what age did you start to listen to metal music, and which was the first metal band and your first concert?
I was 13. I was Smoke on the Water with Deep Purple, and the first concert was Rainbow.
In Helsinki. You know, Smoke on the Water is one of my least favorite songs of all time.
I'm sure Blackmore shares your enthusiasm.
I hate that song. It has a cool intro, yeah. And then it's ruined
when the song. Yeah, basically. Yeah. I guess basically.
Yeah. All right. Anything else?
Well, that's 2 hours and 5 minutes. Your wife's gonna kill you.
She is gonna kill me. She stayed home today. She was sick. So.
Okay. Sick.
She's got a cold. She's been blowing her nose like nonstop.
Coronavirus.
No, it's not coronavirus.
Yeah.
Nope. And if it is, it's very dangerous for her because she does have some conditions. So hopefully it's not coronavirus.
That's not coronavirus. I mean, if she's been staying at home.
Everybody's been sick here. My son's got an ear infection. My wife's got the cold. My favorite's your buddy Gene here. Our favorite song is 303066.
Yeah.
Why?
Horrible song.
Why? You didn't personally meet Richie Blackmore, did you?
No. Unfortunately.
And yes, you are deranged.
What is deranged?
Crazy.
Deranged is crazy?
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm not deranged.
No, not you. Gene, for liking that song.
Ah.
All right. We can say goodbye now because I'm going to piss my pants. And this is the longest Timo Tolkki podcast ever. And if you want to bid on Timo Tolkki's underwear, please contact Timo at ttolkki777@gmail.com.
Yeah. I make a good price.
You do make a good price. Go ahead. Yeah. That's why I say try Facebook. That'd be funny.
Yeah.
Live auction on Facebook.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks, I go to the toilet as well.
Please go to the toilet, and we will see you next time. Oh, wait, hold on. Two more questions. Oh, and Timo, when you write a song, do you consider the pleasure people will take when they listen to it in the case of 303066 and Father?
The pleasure people will take? What does it mean?
Do you consider the pleasure people will take? Are you happy with the way... How do I explain that? I guess does it make you happy that people like those songs or people listen to those songs? I don't know.
If somebody likes my music, it always makes me happy. Of course.
Timo, keep your underwear. Do it in a bottle. What the hell does that mean?
I have to go. I have 1% of battery.
All right, good. Let's drain your battery. You will only buy the sperm. This was fun. Ha ha ha. Do you think people enjoy listening to these songs? No. Nobody likes Stratovarius. Nobody likes Timo's albums. Don't buy any of his shit. And we'll see you
next week.
Well, next time.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye. Okay.